I thought SG-1 killed Apophis. This is your space pod for November 21st, 2011. A couple of weeks ago, we did a space pod on asteroid 2005 YU-55 and where you could see it. It sure would be a pity if we didn't actually show you this little space rock. Now, this 28-frame movie was captured by NASA's Goldstone Solar System radar. YU-55 is rotating faster than real time, which had been about once every 18 hours. Remember that this asteroid came closer to Earth than our own moon. Now, speaking of asteroids coming close to Earth, YouTuber SexyToshi asked, can you please do a topic on 99942 Apophis? Well, it's still a wee bit early to talk about Apophis, but it's actually already started to make the news. Back in December 2004, there were predictions that Apophis had a 2.9% chance of hitting Earth in the year 2029. Now, since then, we've refined projections for Apophis, and it won't be impacting the Earth or our moon in 2029. However, there was a possibility that Apophis would pass through a gravitational keyhole, which would then realign it for impact with Earth in 2036. As more and more time passes, we gather more and more data, and as of October 2009, the probability that Apophis would hit that keyhole was down to 1 in 250,000. That's not to say asteroids don't pose a real and serious threat to the survival of humanity. In reality, our best chance for survival is to become a multi-planetary species, so if something does happen to one planet, we don't all go down with it. Hey, we do it with hard drives and personal data, why not do it with our entire species as well? Now, one way we'll be able to travel to those other stars is via next-generation rockets. Many companies are working to make this happen, but one company you don't hear a lot from is Amazon founder Jeff Bezos' project, Blue Origin.
Engine start. Lift off. Mission D landing. Altitude 450 feet.
Now, what you're watching is Blue Origin's vertical takeoff, vertical landing rocket.
Apogee, 548 feet.
This particular rocket is their second test vehicle, and while they just released the video of this flight, it actually took the air a few months ago. The craft has no capsule, as that's being designed separately, and this is only capable of suborbital flight. But much with how we first landed humans on the moon, you have to take baby steps before you can learn to walk in space.
Figure deploy. 5-0 feet, 3-0, vehicle's down, I copy down.
It may be nearing the Thanksgiving holiday here in the US, but space waits for no one. Here's a list of upcoming flights. Alas, we're still working on the Space Vidcast live channel where you can go to chat with fellow space geeks and watch all of these launches in one place. Until then, hit up the launch provider's webcast, but remember that a chat room is still open. And if you're watching us on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe. We have awesome space pods released weekly, and hopefully sometime soon we'll be able to start up our live channel again. As an added surprise, we were able to attend the LA Space Salon and captured all of Will Pomerantz's amazing session there. Look for that on our channel soon. Really concerned about Apophis, just remember that he was destroyed by the replicators, and I think again by Ball. I guess Apophis does just keep coming back and back.